Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video, we are going to talk about immutability in JavaScript. So this particular series I'm covering as a JavaScript lessons. Here I'm covering some independent topics, like every day I'm publishing one lesson in this JavaScript series, and I'm talking about some particular hardcore JavaScript topics which we sometimes forget, we didn't pay much attention, but these are some of the important aspects. So in previous couple of videos, I talk about asynchronous JavaScript using callback, async await, promises, how to write and why to write promises, why to write async await, how to write async await in the improvised way. Okay, in this video, we are going to talk about immutability. So immutability means, this term is very easy, but sometimes we misunderstand to understand the meaning of this immutability. Immutability means if we are creating some object, then we should create an immutable state. Whenever we are changing that particular object, it should not hamper the existing object. It should always create a new object. So why we need immutability in JavaScript? You can take a different examples like the state management in JavaScript. If you even talk about Redux, MBox, all these frameworks maintains the immutability of an object, immutability of a state. Even if you talk about immutable JS, right? Because JavaScript fundamentally is not providing immutable behavior. There are some utilities, some functions are available on the array or on the functions or on the objects. They are giving you the immutable way of updating things so that you don't update the origin, you always create a new object, new string or new array, right? So the importance of immutability is sometimes when you are writing a code, you will not end up updating your original object, original array. In that way, you will always just return a new array, new object by updating it, and you will get rid of few of the bugs which happens due to not writing the immutable code. Okay, so in JavaScript, primitive values are immutable, but objects are not immutable. If you just take a look onto the simple example, if I just say abcd dot substring, what do you think what it will do? It will give you the new string without changing the existing string. If you do a simple concatenation of two strings, is it changing the existing string like a, b or c, d? These can be two different variables. It is giving you some third variable, right? Similarly, if you do the concat is nothing but like I have this string or some variable whose value is a, b, and I'm doing concat and I'm updating it. I'm concatting c, d value. So it will give you the new string which is having a, b, c, d. Similarly, if you see this var x, okay, if I do x dot push 5, what do you think? It is mutable or immutable? This is mutable because it is mutating the current array. X dot push will update the array and it will insert the 5 value inside it. Okay, so if you talk about like push, which is mutable, similarly everything is kind of a mutable, but we can still achieve immutable way of writing code in JavaScript. If you are familiar with all these different functions, like in Redux we were using object.assign, object.spread operator we were using, so there is a different set of methods which we can use to make objects immutable. Okay, so what all different examples we can say? We'll talk one by one. We'll talk about objects, then arrays and all. So in latest version of JavaScript we have this const, right? So what const is saying is, okay, in const you can actually declare an object, okay, something like this. So even if you are declaring an object like I have y 90, and we start thinking, okay, this is const, you can't change it. But even if you declare something with the const, you can still change the property of an object. X dot y, you can still make it as 100. Okay, so this is also not working. So we have another method, okay, object dot freeze. So here we have object dot freeze we can use to freeze a particular object. So what we can say is, okay, I have this object and I have some properties, like I have y70 and I'm assigning this to some variable const x. So in this way I'm actually creating this immutable object, so it will, you will not be able to change anything in this object. But this object.freeze also doesn't work when your objects are deep nested. Deep nested means if I have something like this, here also I have blah blah or something object like this. So this deep freeze will not work in this particular case of deep nesting, right? This is a simple object I have created. So deep freeze will not work because object.freeze is actually a shallow object freeze. You will be able to freeze the values or the primitives which are defined on the top level. Okay, so this is also not be helpful much for us. So what all other options we can see? So working with immutable objects, so from the code itself we have to create object in such a way that we should be able to make them immutable, like const title. Okay, title is something, okay, JavaScript is my favorite. Okay, now if I just say const new object, here I'm creating new object and there is already one object exist. Sorry. So I have already created one object, const obj, which is having description something. Okay, here I wanted to create a new object that then we can use a spread operator and it will actually append this new property title and it will give you new objects. So in JavaScript we have to use these utility methods. You can actually edit a one particular property or you can also append a new property. Consider that, okay, you have a title only here. In this particular case you are actually overriding the title property and you are getting a new object. Or here you have a title, here you will say I am adding description. So I am adding a description, so it's like I am adding a new property. Okay, if you wanted to remove a property, then that is also an option using this destructuring. Here we have a title and rest you can put in the spread. New obj1. Okay, and you will assign it to new object. In that case, title will be removed, and if you just try to see new object one, it will have only description property. Okay, this is how we can remove the property from the object and we are getting the new object. So in this case, what we are doing is we are not changing anything in the new object. We are not changing in the object while creating the new object. Okay. Let's put it as a my new object if the naming is something like this. So from new object we are creating my new object one. What it is doing, it is new object but it hasn't impacted anything on new object. Similarly, from object I'm creating new object. New object is a new copy which I'm creating by appending a new property onto the object. So object is not changed. Okay, so these are simple examples. Now if you talk about arrays, how array works, so we can talk about simple array methods which are like pop, push, splice, and there are many methods, right? These are not pure. Not pure means they will have a side effect. Whenever you are using them, they will update the existing array. But when we talk about this concat, okay, and there is one more method, slice, these are pure. Okay, what they will do is they will not update the existing array, they will return the new thing. Similarly, we have also like map, filter. These methods you might have used because they are returning the new array without changing the existing array. Okay, so if we just simply talk about concat and all these things, what this works. So we have already seen how spread operator works. Similarly, there is object.assign. Okay, we'll come to array again. So if you talk about this object.assign, this is also same mechanism what we are doing in the spread operator. What it does, consider that you already have an object. It is having x80, okay. You wanted to create a new object out of it. So object.assign takes two arguments. If you wanted to create a new object, then pass it like this and your current object. If you wanted to append some new properties, that you can do here. Third argument, okay, I wanted to append like 700 y. So what it will do is, it will give as a new object, const new object. So the first argument is empty parenthesis, means you are creating a new object from these two objects. So this is the existing object, and you are creating a new object out of it, and you are also adding a new property. You can also override it. So consider x is 80. Okay, I wanted to create x with 90, and you say y with 100. So the new object will have only x 90 and y 100. It will override whatever we have in this object, and it is not changing this object. It is giving us the new object. So it's the same logic what spread operator is doing, but it's a shallow, you can say shallow object assign. What does it mean? Like we have const, I will talk in terms of xy, so I will remove this. Okay, const obi1. Okay, here you have a 700, and what you are doing is const obi2 equal to obi1. Okay, so what generally happens, it's a reference copy. Okay, so what you do is obi2 dot a. If you put 900, then it will also update obi2 dot a will also become 900, because both the objects are sharing the same reference. So this is called reference by copy, because you are directly assigning it. So how to avoid these kind of situations while creating a new object? You just use object.assign, which will do a shallow copy, but only at the top level of objects. What does that mean is, okay, this is a reference copy, clearly I can see that, but how can I create an object 2, obi2? So here I'm creating one nested object, which is having, okay, x900 nested object I have, okay, and what I'm doing is I'm using const obi2 to object.assign, and here I'm trying to create a new object. First argument is an empty object and obi1. It will give me the new object, but what the problem we will face here is the top level is a shallow copy. I mean, whatever you are changing. So I have a obi2 and obi1. So if I do obi2 dot a something like 20, okay, so it will not update obi1 dot a. We are doing shallow copy, so the top level object properties will be deep copied, but still, if you try to access obi2 dot b, obi2.b.x, use update it with 600, then it will also update obi1. So with the object.assign, it's not a pure deep copy. Only the parent level object properties are deep copied. Still, the nested properties are still shared. Okay, so that is the problem. That's why what we do is we just json.stringify. What we do is, if I want to create a new object from this, what I do is json.parse. json.stringify obi1, or there are deep copies utilities available in JavaScript using which we can create a deep copy. Now this new object and this obi2 obi1 are totally separate. You do whatever you wanted to do on obi1 and the new. In the same logic, this spread operator works, because spread operator is nothing but another way of doing object.assign. Okay, so this is pretty much we have done. Now let's go further. Now we are talking about array. Let's back to the array. So if you talk about the immutability using library, right? So that there is an immutable JS is a library. There we can write the code something like this. You can create an immutable list, immutable array. All these things exist with the help of that library. If you don't wanted to get into these things, so here a new book you created, books you have created from this list and new books. So whatever you are creating from these one another, they will be purely deep copied from one another. Okay. Now, if you talk about the concat, concat is purely immutable because concat will give us the new array by concatting that value. Okay. So talk about arrays a little bit. So this is a book which is array of objects, and what we are doing is I'm adding a new book. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm spreading the current book, which is an array, and I'm adding a new book. New book is the new object. Okay, this is how I will try to create a new book without changing anything in the books. So we have already talked about this. You can use object.assign spread operator to create an immutable object. Similarly, you can actually do concat. You can actually slice also. Slice will give you, like, if you wanted to a deep copy. As far as I remember, constex is an array. Okay, what you can do is x dot slice. I think if you do a zero, it will give a deep copy of an array. Similar, it is same as const y. And what you are doing is dot 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 x. It is also a deep copy. It is same exist with objects also. Const new object. Okay, I can actually do a spread of on the current object like new books. But always remember, this works only at the top level. Okay, so you can also write a logic to recursively cloning or recursively doing this shallow copy. In that case, you will achieve it. Okay, so we talked about object.assign, array.concat. Whenever you are doing array.concat, it will actually always going to give you the new arrays. Okay, let's talk about this. So this is common names.concat. It was earlier an array. Okay, like common names. I'm just putting some examples so that we can get more understanding. Now we are doing concat, so it will return the new array. Object.freeze, we talked about, it will freeze only the top level. Even the nested properties will not be frozen. Spread operator, we already talked about. Spread operator works in the same way as object.assign. So what is the benefit we are getting by doing all these things? We have like array.map, array.filter. So consider that this is your array. Sometimes when I ask people, okay, what is the difference between array.map and array.foreach? They are not able to tell. So array.filter or array.map is actually iterate onto the array. Filter will return you some results out of it based on the condition, and using map, you are iterating onto the array and will return from that array based on some manipulation you wanted to do. So what I wanted to do is i plus 10. So what it is doing is it is going to return as the new array const y. We are doing map, and the values will be 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, because we are adding value 10. 13 and same way, right? Similarly, when you are doing filter, so what you are doing, getting is y, as we are getting as a new array without changing the x. So simply like x dot filter. And here we are just saying, okay, if I is greater than 3, return all these. This is the filter condition I have added. So it will not update the existing X array. It is doing a filter onto this array without changing X. So you will get all the elements. Okay, what is the benefits? It is avoiding the side effects. Okay, data changes, change detection makes simple because you know when you are changing the data. Memoization, okay, because if the immutable functions are there, right, then you already know we are not changing the state. We are always returning the new state by doing some execution, right? Easy for testing and less chances for the bugs. Like its best example, you can take a look onto the Redux. In the Redux only, while writing the code, we use object.assign, spread operator, map, filter, concat, slice, all these methods we use. Just avoiding the mutating an object, because we always have to return the new object. Here I will talk about why we need libraries.
only doing a deep copy at the same time. So, you will understand why we need that. Sometimes because we are seeing that only the parent level objects are deep copied.
But what if, what if we wanted to use a library? Yes, so library will give you this freedom instead of writing this code. So I'm going to create a new object. I'm passing the current object using spread, okay? And what I'm doing is I wanted to do a deep copy, okay? I'm not doing json.stringify and then json.parse it. I wanted to do it using spread operator, right? So what I'm doing is this is my current object. Now you override it. So I'm passing this, and here I will be spreading this again, animals.this, then animals.this.this, and then I will be overriding. So this is like a headache, right? For every property, I have to override the objects like this. So this is why we need to have a, like, we already know that this is how it works, but how we can do it? We can use a deep copy libraries. Object.assign spread operator only works at the top level. We can't do a deep copy with them. So either you keep iterating onto the objects and then do a deep copy, okay? In that case, you will be like iterating onto the objects, and you will check if object is a property, then copy it to another object. If object is object, then iterate it again. They like recursive function you can write in this particular case, okay? Or you can write some kind of a utilities. That utilities will take care of copying the objects from source to target. Okay, we talked about like object.assign. Similarly, there are many methods on the objects. All are actually important. Here we talked about object.assign. I mean, immutability is kind of done. I just wanted to talk a few more things. So object.assign, we have object.create. These are some utilities we in our daily life we use them. Object.define property. I think this is object.hasOn property. And similarly, we have object.keys. This you might have used it. Object.entries. Object.values. Some of the important methods. It should be object dot. These are some of the important methods. Similarly, we have object.freeze, which we have seen it. And object.is to compare two methods, two objects, sorry. So object.assign, if you see this, copies the value of all enumerable properties from one source object to another target object. So always remember, it is copying only enumerable properties. And what is this enumerable, configurable, writable? So how we currently create the objects? We just create the object using just empty curly braces, right? Const x, okay, this is my object. But when you do object, but there is another way of doing the same thing, object.define property. So every object properties has three properties: configurable, writable, enumerable. Object.define property, this is my object, and here I'm going to add a new property. Okay, that new property will have like value of that property is something like 52 or something. Okay, and here I can set these properties: writable, enumerable, configurable. If I make writable false, that means this particular property can't be updated. Okay, you always take a look onto this. What I'm saying is, so when you are creating the object simply like this, or simply like object.create, or you are actually copying the y object to x, in these particular cases you are not aware about each and every property. So here we have object x empty property. I'm adding a new property and setting that property value to 44. So here you can set a lot of things: writable, configurable, enumerable. Configurable true, enumerable false. So when you set this enumerable as a false property, that means whenever you are doing object.assign, it will not be copied from object X to object Y. Okay, so I will tell you the story here. Here we have const Y. Okay, what I'm doing is object.assign, and I'm creating empty objects from X. In this particular case, because enumerable is false, for this object X property, this new props will not be copied. Okay. Similarly, we have object.create, create a new object with a specified prototype. So this you might have used at many places, object.create. What we do is, if I wanted to create a new object, const Y equal to object.create. So you can actually pass the existing object which you have already created, like const person object, then you can pass that. So it will inherit the proto of this object and it will create a new object for you. Okay. So object.create methods are create a new object using an existing object as the prototype of newly created object. So this is a pure example of inheritance in the object, using object.create, creating a new object and passing the existing object into it. Object.define property, we have seen this. Object.hasOn property. So sometimes what happens is you are creating new object by extending the parent object. In that case, if you try to see object.hasOn property which you are inheriting from someone else, there you can check, is this property belongs to this original object or you inherited from somewhere else? So that will be helpful. So if you are inheriting from somewhere else, object.hasOn property will give you false. Object.keys, values, entries. So this will give you just an array by iterating objects. Like this is your array. Okay, you have this index. Array is also an object. If you see what it contains is, it contains the index, which is 0. At 0th index, you have the value 1. Okay, first index, you have the value 1, right? So object.keys will give you the keys 0, 1, 2, 3. Object.values will give you the array of values, which is 1, 2, 3. Object.entries will give you the pair of key value pairs. Okay, so these are some of the methods which are important one, but you can also take a look onto the shallow copy and deep copy of objects, why object.assign or the spread operator are shallow copy and how you can achieve the deep copy using either recursively iterating onto the objects and keep doing a spread operator again and again, or you can also use a utility library, or simple one is you can actually stringify and parse an object. Okay, that's it we have for this session. I hope you liked it. If you like all the content, please like, share and subscribe. Thanks everyone.